Welcome to the training video for reprocessing Olympus EVIS Xera and Xera 2 GI endoscopes. This program will demonstrate a cleaning and disinfection procedure suitable for most Olympus gastroscopes, colonoscopes, and duodenoscopes. This video supports but is not intended to replace the specific reprocessing information provided in the instruction manuals that accompanied your endoscope when purchased. Consult your endoscope's instruction manual for specific details regarding the particular model endoscope that you are reprocessing. Only trained personnel should reprocess medical endoscopes. When performed according to instructions, endoscope reprocessing is safe and effective, as this video will demonstrate. To perform the reprocessing procedure, the following Olympus reprocessing accessories will be needed: a water-resistant cap, a reusable or single-use channel cleaning brush, a reusable or single-use channel opening cleaning brush, a leakage tester, channel plug and injection tube, a suction cleaning adapter, air-water channel cleaning adapter, an auxiliary water tube if you are reprocessing an endoscope with an auxiliary water channel, a washing tube if you are reprocessing an endoscope with an elevator wire channel, 5 and 30 cc syringes for injecting reprocessing fluids through the endoscope, a source of suction to suction fluids through the endoscope, and either an Olympus light source or maintenance unit to provide a source of air for leak testing. Consult your endoscope's instruction manual for a list of required general reprocessing supplies. Before we start, a few words about personal protective equipment. Reprocessing chemicals are toxic, and patient debris presents an infection risk to reprocessing personnel. Always wear appropriate personal protective equipment and comply with local hospital guidelines as well as applicable state and federal regulations. Appropriate protective equipment may include a moisture-resistant gown, chemical-resistant gloves of proper fit and adequate length to prevent skin exposure, and protective eyewear or a face mask. Be sure to remove soiled personal protective equipment before leaving the reprocessing area. Before we look at the individual steps involved in endoscope reprocessing, here is a general overview of the procedure. There are four major steps to reprocessing a video endoscope. The first step is pre-cleaning, which is performed at the bedside immediately after the patient procedure. Pre-cleaning removes gross debris and prevents patient material from drying onto the endoscope. The second step is leakage testing. Leakage testing ensures that the endoscope is air and fluid tight. A leaking endoscope will be severely damaged if fluids enter the instrument. Leaking endoscopes also present an infection control risk. The third step is manual cleaning. This involves thoroughly cleaning the exterior surface, all internal lumens of the endoscope, and all removable parts by wiping, flushing, brushing, and rinsing all surfaces. The final step in the process is high-level disinfection or sterilization. High-level disinfection is performed by immersing the endoscope in an FDA-cleared high-level disinfectant and ensuring that all surfaces are contacted for the specified time and at the temperature recommended by the disinfectant manufacturer. As an alternative to chemical disinfection, the endoscope may be sterilized using an approved method indicated in the reprocessing manual. Before we discuss the specific steps involved in reprocessing a flexible endoscope, it is helpful to understand the construction of the internal channels or lumens within the endoscope. This drawing shows the channels found in a standard gastroscope or colonoscope. The largest channel is the instrument channel, through which biopsy forceps, snares, and other endotherapy devices are inserted. This channel is also used to suction fluids from the patient during the examination. GI endoscopes also contain a small channel that brings air from an external air pump through the distal tip of the endoscope to insufflate the patient during the examination. A second small channel supplies water to wash the lens on the distal tip. In addition to these channels, your endoscope may have one of two special channels, either an auxiliary water channel or an elevator wire channel. The auxiliary water channel is most commonly found on colonoscopes, although some gastroscopes also have this feature. This channel brings water from a syringe or pump to the distal tip of the endoscope and is used to wash debris from the patient's mucosa in order to provide the endoscopist with a better view. If your endoscope has this special auxiliary water channel, you will find a connector for this channel on the light guide connector of the endoscope. ERCP endoscopes or duodenoscopes also contain a special channel. All duodenoscopes have a distal movable part called an elevator that is used to manipulate accessories which have been passed through the biopsy channel. The wire that controls movement of this elevator runs in a channel called the elevator wire channel. You will find a connector to access this channel on the control section of every duodenoscope. Check the endoscope to determine if either of these two special channels is present. If so, follow the additional steps outlined in this video to reprocess these channels as well. Reprocess every channel, including special channels, regardless of whether that channel has been used in the procedure or not. Pre-cleaning is the first reprocessing step and is performed at the bedside immediately after the patient procedure. Pre-cleaning is critical to remove gross patient debris from the endoscope before it has a chance to dry. You will need a 500 milliliter container of detergent solution nearby. First, turn off the video processor and light source. Then, gently wipe the insertion tube from the control section to the distal tip with a lint-free cloth or sponge soaked in detergent solution. Turn on the suction pump. Immerse the distal end of the endoscope in detergent solution and aspirate for 30 seconds. Remove the tip from the detergent and aspirate air for 10 seconds. Now, turn off the suction pump. Next, we will flush water and air into the air-water channel. With the light source off, remove the air-water valve and place it in detergent solution. Insert the air-water channel cleaning adapter. Turn on the light source and switch the airflow regulator to maximum output. Immerse the distal end of the endoscope in the detergent container. Depress the air-water channel cleaning adapter valve for 30 seconds. Release the valve to feed air through the air-water channel for 10 seconds. If your endoscope has an auxiliary water channel, connect an injection tube to the auxiliary water connector and flush detergent through this channel. Expel this detergent by flushing with air. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, connect the washing tube to the elevator wire channel connector and flush 15 cc's of detergent. Followed by air through the elevator wire channel. Note that to flush fluid through the elevator wire channel, you must use a small 5 cc syringe. Turn off the light source. Remove all valves and place them in detergent solution. Disconnect the suction tube, water container, and videoscope connector. Disconnect the endoscope from the light source. Now, transport the endoscope to the reprocessing room. The following step should be performed prior to immersing your endoscope in any fluid. Visually, inspect the water-resistant cap for damage. If it is damaged or wet, use another cap. Attach the water-resistant cap to the endoscope. Remember, never connect or disconnect the water-resistant cap while the cap or the endoscope is immersed. Doing so will damage the endoscope. Attach the leakage tester to the MU1 maintenance unit or to an Olympus light source. Turn on the air supply. If you are using a light source, be sure to set the airflow rate to its maximum setting. Depress the pin inside the connector and confirm that air comes out of the cap. Now, attach the leakage tester to the endoscope. Note that as you pressurize the inside of the endoscope, the rubber sheath on the distal tip of the endoscope will expand. Now, immerse the endoscope in clean water. Do not leak test in detergent, as detergent will hinder visualization of leaks. With the angulation locks in the free position, angulate the endoscope tip in all directions. Deflecting the tip will help expose any pinholes that may exist in the bending section rubber. Initially, you may see a few bubbles clinging to the insertion tube or coming out of a channel opening. These do not indicate a leak. Wipe away any bubbles clinging to the instrument. Also, manipulate the scope buttons to check for leaks. If you see no source of continuous bubbles emanating from the endoscope is air and fluid tight. In contrast, if you do observe a continuous stream of bubbles, the endoscope is leaking. Leaks like this will allow fluids to penetrate and damage the endoscope. If you observe such a leak, do not turn the air supply off. Rather, remove the endoscope from the water, blow out the channels with air, and dry the endoscope prior to turning off the leakage tester. Contact Olympus for instructions on how to reprocess a leaking endoscope prior to sending the endoscope to Olympus for repair. If no leaks are observed, remove the endoscope from the water. Disconnect the leakage tester from the air supply and wait for the bending section rubber to return to its normal size. Detach the leakage tester from the water-resistant cap. Leakage testing is now complete. The next step is to manually clean the endoscope. Effective cleaning will remove more than 99% of the bioburden from the endoscope. Failure to adequately clean the endoscope will reduce the efficacy of any high-level disinfection or sterilization procedure which follows and poses an infection control risk. Prepare a basin of detergent solution. Always use freshly prepared detergent at the specified concentration. Never reuse detergent solution. Carefully coil the endoscope and completely immerse it in detergent solution. Use a soft brush or lint-free cloth to clean the exterior surface of the endoscope. Pay particular attention to the distal tip and ensure that the air-water nozzle is free of debris. Take care not to scratch the small lenses. Perform all brushing while submerged to prevent splashing. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, raise the elevator and carefully brush around and under the elevator mechanism. Next, brush the channels. Start by inspecting the channel cleaning brush for any damage. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, make sure that you lower the elevator before brushing the channel. There are two portions to the suction channel that require individual brushing. One extends from the valve housing to the distal tip. The other extends from the valve housing to the light source connector. To brush the suction channel within the insertion tube, hold the channel cleaning brush at a 45-degree angle and insert the brush into the opening in the side of the suction valve housing. Use short strokes to advance the brush through the insertion tube until it emerges from the distal tip. Remove any debris from the bristles with your fingers and gently pull the brush back through the channel. Inspect and clean the bristles again. Repeat this process until you cannot see any further debris on the bristles. To brush the suction channel within the universal cord, insert the brush into the center of the suction valve opening. Pass the brush through the universal cord until it emerges from the suction connector. Clean the bristles and withdraw the brush. Once again, clean the bristles and repeat until no debris is observed on the brush tip. The next step is to clean the channel openings. Carefully insert about one half of the channel opening brush into the suction valve housing. Rotate the brush and remove. Clean the bristles. Repeat this process until no visible debris remains. Now move down to the instrument channel port. Insert the brush. Rotate and remove. Clean the bristles. And repeat until no visible debris remains. Now that the channels have been brushed, the next step is to flush the channels with detergent solution to remove any remaining debris. Connect the endoscope to a source of suction. Attach the suction cleaning adapter to the instrument port. Immerse the distal tip of the endoscope and the weighted end of the suction cleaning adapter in detergent solution. Turn on the suction pump. Cover the suction valve housing with your finger and aspirate detergent solution for 30 seconds. Turn the suction pump off and disconnect the tubes. To flush the air-water channel, attach the channel plug to the valve housings and instrument port. Attach the injection tube to the air pipe, the suction port, and the water and air connectors. Next, attach a 30cc syringe to the air-water channel port of the injection tube. With the intake filter immersed in detergent, use the syringe to flush 90cc of detergent solution through the air-water channels. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject detergent into the auxiliary water channel. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, use a syringe and injection tube to inject detergent into the elevator wire channel. Now that the internal channels are filled with detergent, wipe the external surfaces with a soft sponge or lint-free cloth to remove any debris. Soak the endoscope and accessories in detergent for the time recommended by the detergent manufacturer. The next step is to rinse the detergent from the endoscope. It is critical to remove all traces of detergent, as it may interact with or inhibit the activity of the high-level disinfectant or sterilant. Transfer the endoscope and accessories to a basin or sink filled with clean water. Wipe all external surfaces of the equipment with a clean cloth. Now, rinse the channels. With the suction intake filter in the water, use the syringe to flush 90cc of water through the suction channels. Move the syringe to the air water port and repeat to flush rinsed water through the air water channels. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject water into the auxiliary water channel. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, use a syringe to inject water into the elevator wire channel. The next step is to purge the channels with air to remove the rinse water. Transfer the endoscope and accessories to an empty basin. Use the syringe to flush 90cc of air through the air water channels. Repeat this process for the suction channel. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject air into the auxiliary water channel, expelling all water from this channel as well. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, inject air into the elevator wire channel. Now, use a lint-free cloth to dry the external surfaces of the endoscope, channel plug, and injection tube. Visually inspect the endoscope and cleaning accessories. If any debris remains, the manual cleaning process must be repeated. The endoscope must be completely clean before proceeding with high-level disinfection or sterilization. The next step in reprocessing the endoscope is either high-level disinfection or sterilization. If you are using an automated endoscope reprocessor or AER to perform these steps, please refer to the AER's instruction manual. If you will be using an AER, you may want to skip directly to the next chapter. However, if you are performing manual disinfection, here are the steps. Start by immersing the endoscope, channel plug, and injection tubes in a compatible high-level disinfectant solution. The solution must be tested for efficacy and prepared according to the manufacturer's recommendations regarding temperature and contact time. With the intake filter immersed in disinfectant solution, use the syringe to inject 90 cc's of disinfectant into the air-water channels. Repeat this procedure with the syringe attached to the suction channel port. The endoscope's air, water, and suction channels are now completely filled with disinfectant solution. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject disinfectant into the auxiliary water channel. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, inject disinfectant into the elevator wire channel. Now, disconnect all accessories while making sure all items remain submerged. Cover the disinfectant basin with a tight-fitting lid in order to contain the disinfectant vapors. Disinfect the endoscope and reprocessing equipment by soaking them in accordance with the disinfectant manufacturer's instructions. Use a timer to confirm you are achieving the proper contact time. After soaking the equipment in the disinfectant solution for the recommended period of time, reconnect the reprocessing accessories to the endoscope. Remove the intake filter from the disinfectant solution so that it will pick up air. Connect a sterile syringe to the air-water channel port and pump at least 3 times to expel the disinfectant from the air-water channels. Move the syringe to the suction port and pump at least 3 times to expel disinfectant from the suction channel. At the end of the process, you should observe air bubbles exiting the channel openings. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject air into the auxiliary water channel, expelling disinfectant solution from this channel as well. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, inject air to expel disinfectant from the elevator wire channel. Now that all of the channels have been emptied of disinfectant, the next step is rinsing. It is very important to remove all disinfectant solution from the endoscope. Residual disinfectant is toxic and can injure the next patient examined with the endoscope. Start by transferring the endoscope and accessories to a clean basin filled with fresh rinse water. If sterile water is not available, fresh tap water or water that has been processed or filtered to improve its microbiological quality may be used instead. However, always consult with the infection control representative within your facility on the hospital's policy regarding water quality. With the instrument submerged, use a fresh, sterile, lint-free cloth to thoroughly wipe and rinse all external surfaces. Next, with the intake filter immersed in the rinse water, use the syringe to flush 90 cc's of rinse water through the air-water channels. Move the syringe to the suction connector and do the same to rinse the suction channel. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject water into the auxiliary water channel. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, inject water into the elevator wire channel in order to rinse this channel as well. Remove the endoscope and accessories from the rinse water basin and place them into a clean, dry basin. Use the syringe once again to flush all water out of the suction channel. Move the syringe and flush out the air-water channels. Detach the injection tube. Attach a clean suction tube to the suction connector. Turn on the suction pump and aspirate air for 15 seconds. Turn off the suction pump. Disconnect the channel plug and the suction tube. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to inject air into the auxiliary water channel. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, inject air into the elevator wire channel in order to expel rinse water from this channel as well. Use a sterile lint-free cloth to thoroughly dry the external surfaces of the endoscope and reprocessing accessories. In the event that non-sterile water was used for the final rinse, perform an alcohol flush of the endoscope channels. If using sterile water for the rinse, Olympus requires an alcohol flush to aid in the drying process. Flushing the endoscope channels with alcohol promotes drying of the channels and inhibits the growth of waterborne microorganisms. Start by preparing a beaker with 70% ethyl or isopropyl alcohol. Immerse the injection tube intake filter into the alcohol. Flush the air-water channel with 90 cc's of alcohol. Move the syringe to the suction port and flush the suction channel with 90 cc's of alcohol. Remove the injection tube's intake filter from the beaker. Flush the suction channel with 90 cc's of air. Move the syringe to the air-water channel port and flush with 90 cc's of air. If you are reprocessing an endoscope with a special channel, use a syringe to flush alcohol into the auxiliary water channel. Follow this with an injection of air to expel the alcohol. If you are reprocessing a duodenoscope, flush alcohol into the elevator wire channel. And follow this with an injection of air to expel the alcohol. Disconnect the channel plug and injection tubes from the endoscope. Use a sterile lint-free cloth moistened with 70% alcohol to remove any remaining water drops on the external surfaces of the endoscope, the channel plug, and the injection tube. Use sterile cotton swabs to dry inside the valve housings and instrument port. Your endoscope is now reprocessed and ready for use in examining another patient or for storage and use at a later time. If you plan to store the endoscope, ensure that all channels of the endoscope are dry. Wet channels promote the growth of microorganisms and present an infection control risk. Prior to storing the endoscope, remove the water-resistant cap from the light guide connector and make sure that all valves have been removed from the endoscope. Also, check that the angulation locks are in their free position. Colonoscopes with adjustable stiffness should be set to their most flexible condition. Now, hang the endoscope in a storage cabinet. The distal tip should hang freely, with the insertion tube as straight as possible and avoiding contact with other instruments. A word of caution: do not use the endoscope's carrying case to store patient-ready equipment. Any endoscope placed in its carrying case must be reprocessed prior to use with another patient. Now that the endoscope has been reprocessed and stored, a few words regarding the reprocessing of ancillary equipment. Note that the water-resistant cap, channel plug, and injection tube have been reprocessed along with the endoscope. This leaves the valves, suction cleaning adapter, reusable cleaning brushes, and mouthpiece to be reprocessed separately. Using a clean soft brush, sponge, or lint-free cloth, meticulously clean the outer surfaces of all parts in the detergent solution. Clean the bristle sections of the cleaning brushes thoroughly while immersed. While immersed, depress and release the pistons of the air-water valve, the suction valve, and the air-water channel cleaning adapter to ensure the detergent solution contacts all crevices. Use the channel cleaning brush to thoroughly brush the openings of the suction and air-water valves and the air-water channel cleaning adapter. Be careful not to scratch the valve seals with the brushes. Continue brushing until there is no visible debris. Clean all brushes while immersed in the detergent solution. Use a syringe to flush through the biopsy valve. Also, flush the suction cleaning adapter with detergent. When you have finished flushing all parts, let them soak in detergent solution for the amount of time and at the temperature recommended by the detergent manufacturer. After the appropriate amount of time, remove the valves and cleaning equipment from the detergent basin and place them in clean rinse water. Visually inspect all parts. If any debris remains, ultrasonically clean the parts at 40 kHz for 5 minutes. If an ultrasonic cleaner is not available, place the components back into the detergent solution and repeat manual cleaning. While immersed in the rinse water, flush the valves and the air-water channel cleaning adapter. Depress and release the pistons while flushing. Attach the syringe to the suction cleaning adapter and flush the tube with clean water. Remove the valves, brushes, and adapters from the water and thoroughly dry them with a clean, lint-free cloth. Attach a syringe to the suction cleaning adapter and flush with air to dry the inside of the tube. Thoroughly dry all parts with a clean, lint-free cloth. Now that the parts are clean, it is highly recommended that you autoclave all parts that are compatible with steam sterilization. If you choose to high-level disinfect these components rather than sterilize them, immerse the valves, brushes, and adapters into a disinfectant solution, which has been prepared according to the manufacturer's instructions. Use a syringe to flush inside the valves and pistons. Depress and release the pistons on each valve while submerged. Ensure that disinfectant solution contacts all internal surfaces. Flush the interior and recessed parts of the biopsy valve while immersed. Rub the bristles of all brushes to make sure all air bubbles have been removed. Fill a syringe with disinfectant solution. Attach it to the suction cleaning adapter and flush with disinfectant. After removing the air bubbles from all parts, soak the parts for the specified amount of time and at the temperature recommended by the disinfectant manufacturer. After disinfecting for the appropriate amount of time, remove the components from the disinfectant basin and place them in clean rinse water. Attach a syringe to the suction cleaning adapter. Flush air to expel all disinfectant solution and place it in the rinse water. While immersed, depress and release the pistons on the valves and on the air-water channel cleaning adapter. Use a syringe to fill the suction cleaning adapter. Remove all parts from the rinse water. Attach a syringe to the suction cleaning adapter and flush air to expel all rinse water. Thoroughly dry all parts with a clean, lint-free cloth. If non-sterile water is used for rinsing, the parts must be wiped and given a final flush with 70% ethyl or 70% isopropyl alcohol. Prepare a container with the alcohol. Fill the syringe with alcohol. Attach the syringe to the suction cleaning adapter and flush. Use the syringe to flush air through the suction cleaning adapter to expel all alcohol from inside the tube. Flush with air 3 more times. Place the adapter on a dry, clean cloth. Immerse the cleaning brushes in alcohol. Agitate, remove, and place them on a dry, clean cloth. Immerse all remaining parts in alcohol. Depress and release the pistons on all valves while immersed. Dip remaining parts in alcohol and place on the cloth. Using a clean, lint-free cloth or gauze, thoroughly dry all parts. You have now reviewed the steps required to safely reprocess your Olympus GI endoscopes. To summarize, there are four major parts to endoscope reprocessing. Number one, it is mandatory to pre-clean the instrument at the bedside to remove patient debris immediately following the procedure. Pre-cleaning prevents patient material from drying onto internal and external surfaces of the endoscope. Two, leakage testing is required to ensure that the channels and insertion tube are not damaged and that all seals are air and watertight. Routine leakage testing prevents costly fluid invasion and therefore costly instrument repairs. Never use an endoscope that has a known leak on a patient, as this can present an infection control risk. 3. A critical step is meticulous manual cleaning with a detergent or enzymatic solution. Use appropriate brushes and cloths to thoroughly clean all exterior surfaces and internal lumens. High-level disinfection or sterilization is the next step. High-level disinfection kills or inactivates any remaining vegetative bacteria, viruses, and fungi. It is important that you test the disinfectant solution regularly for potency and use it at the temperature and for the contact time recommended by the manufacturer. Also remember, disinfectant solutions are toxic. Wear appropriate personal protective equipment throughout the entire procedure, and thoroughly rinse all disinfectant from the endoscope prior to the final alcohol flush drying procedure. This training video presents a general procedure for endoscope reprocessing. Consult the instruction manuals that came with your endoscope for specific details on how each particular endoscope must be reprocessed. Certain model endoscopes may have features that require additional specific steps. Olympus also offers on-site and off-site training, wall charts, and other reprocessing materials and aids. Refer to the Olympus America website at www.olympusamerica.com for additional information. Thank you for viewing this video on GI endoscope reprocessing. Olympus, your vision, our future.